Well, today in the studio, I have with me a gentleman who is really going to kind of open your eyes and your ears to, you know, some wonderful things that are going on, not only in his life, but in his personal music ministry. And his name is Melvin Spence. Melvin, welcome.
Thank you. Thank you, Anya. Thank you for having me. It's a pleasure to be here.
Well, it's an honor to have you. And, you know, I'll tell you, we've kind of talked back and forth, and I know I found out about you and learned of you through Charlena, the Soulful Psalmist.
Mm-hmm.
You know, she speaks very, very highly of you. And now that I've had a chance to listen to some of your music, I can definitely tell why. Melvin, tell our listeners just a little bit about yourself. I know that there are a lot of people who do know you because you're part of Word of Faith. That's under the leadership of Dale Bronner. But tell us more about yourself.
Well, I'm 39 years old.
Okay.
I'm single.
All righty.
And I love the Lord.
Oh, yes.
Saved, sanctified, filled with the Holy Ghost.
Oh, that's first and foremost.
Yes.
That's first and foremost.
Absolutely. I've been in the Atlanta area for about 7 years now.
Okay.
I've been a member at Word of Faith for that time. And it's been a pleasure. It's been a ride.
Well, you know, we were talking just a little bit earlier, and you were telling me how you came to Atlanta, and
mm-hmm.
you know, that's just such an amazing story. Mm-hmm. But and share that, just a little of that with our listeners now.
Yeah, well, about 7 years ago, I was in Atlanta, San Diego. I was
okay.
living in downtown San Diego, and I was living in a roach-infested hotel. I was totally depressed, and I was drinking about a fifth of whiskey a day.
Wow.
And I had come to Atlanta prior.
Okay.
Around the Olympics, and I went through a drug and alcohol program there.
Okay.
And a couple of gentlemen from Word of Faith came and did Bible studies there, and that's how I was exposed to Word of Faith.
Wow.
And so I left that program, and I went back to
okay.
San Diego. And so as time evolved, 7 years ago, like I said, I was living in this hotel. I was depressed. I was drinking a fifth of whiskey a day. And I called Bishop Bronner, and I said, "Sir, my name is Melvin Spence, and I'm about to drink myself to death."
Why, you just, those are the words you used.
That's the words I said. And actually, I left a message.
Incredible.
And one day, I was sitting at home, and the phone rang. And he said, "May I speak to Melvin Spence?" And I said, "Speak." And he said, "This is Dale Bronner from Atlanta, Georgia."
Mm.
And he just began to speak some things into my life. He began to say, "You know what, God will turn your misery into ministry. He will take your mess and give you a message."
Wow.
And he says, "God has so much in store for you." He says, "Son," he said, "you come on to Atlanta. Don't you worry about where you're going to stay. Don't worry about where you're going to work. You just come and let God heal you." And India, I've done just that. And I've been at Word of Faith. I've been singing in a praise team, in a choir. And God has just been doing a wonderful work in my life. I get choked up just thinking about it.
Praise God. Yeah. Praise God that, you know, praise God first and foremost that you heard Bishop Dale Bronner's message, that
yes.
you opened your ears and you opened your eyes and you opened your heart and you said, "Okay, I hear you and I receive that." And you didn't allow yourself to go down that path of self-destruction. That is such an amazing story. I know that there are people out there who are experiencing, you know, something similar, or who feel that, you know, life is just not worth living, and how am I going to get to the next stage of my life? And that is so inspirational. Now tell us, I know you came to Atlanta,
mm-hmm.
and now what happened once you got here?
Well, once I got here, like I said, Word of Faith, they provided me a place to stay.
Okay.
And I didn't come, you know, looking for a handout.
Okay.
I went to the church and I said, "You know what?" I said, "Is there something that I could do
okay.
to earn some money?"
Mm.
And Reverend Garman at the time, who was the executive pastor, he gave me a paint bucket and a brush, and he said, "Paint some walls." And I was down there painting, and I got money to receive a MARTA card, you know, and
yes.
I started looking for work, and I found a job within 2 weeks.
So you're a man, you were also, regardless of the
mm-hmm.
of the depression, regardless of where you were,
mm-hmm.
you came in and you said, "You knew, I'm a man."
Yes.
And mm-hmm. I can do this. You gave me a hand up, Mm-hmm. You gave me a hand up, not a handout.
That's right.
And I want to be able to do something for myself. Tell me what I can do. And that's what they did.
Absolutely.
Wow. Mm-hmm. Amazing. That is incredible. Yeah. You know what? We're gonna continue the interview, but I'm not going to have the listeners wait any longer, because in that story, there is a message. Mm-hmm. And this man, Melvin Spence, has a song in his heart, and we want to play one of those songs right now and just and share with you, once that song is over, more of Melvin Spence in this interview. This is why I do food for your soul. Melvin, mm-hmm. Melvin Spence, you know, while you were singing your song, Begging for Change, mm-hmm. God just revealed to me, you know, I have had a very, very dear friend who unfortunately was going through quite a lot, and she decided that the best way to handle her situation was to no longer be with us. Mm-hmm. And you know, when Bishop Dale Bronner reached out to you and said, come on, you know, that was that time to be able to feed that life into you, and you took hold, and I'm just so glad that he did. And I am just so excited about you.